Poussin, or spring chicken, or baby chicken, is the ultimate comfort food for me. It's not as flavoursome as a good French chicken, but it's way more forgiving. Even if you brought the temperature of the breast above 67, it'll still be tender. So, today, we're just gonna roast them, garnish with a bit of shimeji mushrooms, and some micro herbs. Let's do it. I normally don't remove the wishbones from poussins because they're just so easy to carve. There's no point. But one thing I would do is to clean the inside of the bird with paper towel so it will not cloud your jus when they come out. As you can see, this is what you're removing. Same for the other one. For me, it's one bird per person, but then I tend to be very hungry all the time, so please adjust accordingly. Now, we salt our bird inside and out. The old school chefs would tell you only season the inside, but honestly, it doesn't really matter. About 0.6% to body weight, if you really want to be precise. We're gonna baste it and serve it with the jus, so it doesn't really matter how uneven they are. Perfect. One dry hand, one wet hand, makes things easier. Now, to make them slightly easier to handle and to even out the cooking, we're gonna truss them. Basically, what you want to do is to go under the bird and you bring the legs together, turn here, and you go under the legs. You pull, so this tightens the whole thing. You go around the bird, between the wings, go under, between the other side of the wings, and you tie a butcher's knot. Go under once, twice, three times, and you pull quite hard. Tie it again, one, trussed chicken. All you want to do now is to tuck the wingtips under to get an even better shape. Beautiful. Now this goes onto our roasting tray. Same with the other one. So strange to do it that way. It's like tying a bow tie for your friend. Cross, turn, go under, tie it. Now, goes under the wings, or you're on the other side, butcher's knot. One, two, three. The reason why we're doing this is when you do a butcher's knot, once you pull, even when you release, it doesn't really go back that much. And that helps you adjust. Now, do the other knot. Boom. Perfect. Trim this off. So, because of the thin skin, you never really get crispy skin with poussin. Let's be very honest. Even if you deep fry them, the skin will not be crispy. What we want is to get a decent amount of browning and cook the legs. So what we do, this is what Mr. Jacques Pepin does as well. We start on one side. So the thigh meat gets more heat from the oven. After 15 minutes, we flip it to the other side. And after 15 minutes, on their backs, we brown the breasts. So, just to help it brown evenly, a bit of olive oil to get it started. Any oil would do. We can always skim off the fat at the end, so don't worry. So now this goes into a preheated oven at 180 fan and we'll turn it every 15 minutes. I'll see you then. And while that's in the oven, we'll prep the mushrooms. So the reason why I'm cooking the mushrooms separately is because during the initial stage of cooking, they release a lot of liquid. And I don't want to dilute the chicken jus with the liquid. So we're gonna saute them in the pan, concentrate the flavors, and add the shimeji to the chicken during the last 15 minutes of cooking. So instead of diluting, they can soak up some of the chickeny goodness. So prep them, very simple. Trim off the roots. Now you have very cute, cartoon-like individual mushrooms. I tend to get rid of the really tiny ones because they just burn. You can dry these and they make amazing dashi. It looks like a lot, but they're gonna shrink once they hit the pan. Speaking of, let's preheat the pan. High heat. Hot pan, olive oil. Swirl it around. Shimeji goes in. And you season with a bit of salt. This will also help them release their liquids. Black pepper. You break up the twins and the triplets. Just for presentation. So like any fresh mushrooms, they first have to release their liquid, then they get to start browning. So it takes longer than most people think. If you take them out too early, you end up with watery mushroom with not much flavor. If I were serving this on its own, once they start browning, I would add a bit of minced shallots and minced garlic. But because we're mopping up the chicken juices, I'm gonna leave it plain. As you can see, even for mushrooms that small, it takes a while to cook and brown. It's been what, 7-8 minutes? So bear that in mind when you're cooking bigger mushrooms. All right, that's decent enough browning for me. So we'll leave them on the pan to keep warm. And when there's 15 minutes left, we'll add at least some of them to the chicken. I'll see you then. All right, after 3 flips and 45 minutes, we check on our chicken. Look at this, it smells incredible. Always, just to be on the safe side, thickest part of the thigh. Now, we let the chicken rest while we skim off some of the fat. Of course, we drain off the extra jus. As you can see, because we cleaned the inside of the chicken, we have very clear juices coming out. By the way, how you rest your chicken has no effect on where the juices go, because liquid travel due to osmosis, difference in density, not gravity. There's no need to waste time making those tinfoil donuts so juices flow to the breast. They won't. Now, we skim off some of the fat. This is a corn-fed poussin, so there's quite a bit. And look how beautiful the mushrooms are, huh? You can use the fat to saute your next batch of mushrooms. That would be amazing. Decent bowl. So we'll give the chicken at least 10 minutes to rest. Ideally a bit more, so that the temperature gradient evens out. When you think about it, the outside of the chicken was exposed to 150 degrees Celsius of heat, and the heat slowly permeates inwards. So now the outside is way hotter than the inside. So we rest because A, we want to give time for the temperature to even out, and B, we want the protein fibers that are tensed up to have time to slowly relax. This is what changes the moisture retention. So at least 10 minutes. And then we'll carve. All right, after about 15 minutes, let's carve. You remove the strings. The easiest thing to do is first you remove the legs. Just carve between. And then you lift until you hear a pull. Now, all you have to do is to follow the bone. You took the oyster, of course. The chef's treat. And it's optional, but you can trim off this tough bit. Presentation, making it easier for your guests. Find the joint and you cut. That's one leg, same goes the other leg. Cut between the breast and the leg and you pull. You hear the crack, take the oyster. Now, the breast, just carve and you follow the bone. We didn't remove the wishbone, but as you can see here, the yield that you sacrifice by not doing so is so low, I rarely bother. And whatever you don't eat, will make a very gelatinous broth that will be perfect for making sauces. This is what you gave up, this tiny, tiny bit for not removing the wishbone, so I wouldn't bother. Wing tip goes away. Wings on the other side of the breast. Again, you follow the bones. And we save this for stock. Now we carve the other one. I mean, look at this beauty. Everything's perfectly cooked. I like to plate it so people can choose. This is the breast side. This is the leg side, of course. Now, just some extra garnish on top because we have them. By the way, I use shimeji mushrooms, but honestly, you can use anything or skip the mushrooms altogether. It will be equally tasty. And remember the fat that we skimmed off? Just a bit on top for garnish. Bit. Micro coriander, purely for garnish, definitely optional. The beauty of micro herbs, they really bring the sense of occasion. And they're not that expensive, let's be honest. And that's perfect. Imagine some rice to mop up all the chicken juices afterwards. Comfort food for two very hungry people. This is roasted poussin with shimeji mushrooms. I hope you enjoy.